I'm McKenna Guerrero, and this is Center Stage. Today we're joined with Floral Jacket. Now guys, if you would please introduce yourselves and your roles in the band.
I'm Gabby Buchanan and I'm lead vocalist and rhythm guitarist.
I'm James O'Hara, I play guitar.
I'm Caitlin Rivera, play drums.
I am Angel Tapia and I play bass, really good.
Now guys, I'm sure coming up with a band name is super tricky, but how did you guys come up with Floral Jacket and what does it mean to you guys?
We started when we were in James' garage, and we didn't have a name for probably like 2 months, and it was a little tricky, but we kind of wanted something that was a mixture of feminine and masculine, and a friend was talking about anything that has to do with floral, and then they were talking about leather jacket, so we put together Floral Jacket.
Thank you. are so many music styles out there. Yours just so happens to be indie rock, but can you explain what indie rock is?
Okay, so we're in the studio, and her friend, maybe Orlando's friend, his name's Will, he was like doing the recording stuff for us and just helping us all out. And I asked him, I was like, Will, like, what do you even call this? He was like, yeah, I don't know. You kind of got that like indie acid surf rock thing going on. And I was like, cool, Will. All right. I like that. But yeah, I just say like, yeah, indie band.
It feels really good to actually be able to play it so that you can understand really what the genre is, because indie rock is, I feel like it's just a category, and then there's several subcategories under there. Like there's surf rock, there's indie acoustic, there's a whole bunch of stuff, but the fact is that they're independent, and so they're just one big category and then a whole bunch of like subcategories that I think fits perfectly for what James was talking about earlier. So
every artist has their own writing techniques, or you get inspired by many things. I mean, look at Taylor Swift, it's always breakups. But what inspires you guys?
Well, I think usually the way that, at least how I write, is we write after we play the music. Like we do an instrumental, one of us would have an idea and they'd come up and be like, guys, we should do this, really do it. And then when it comes to writing it, you think of, for me at least, I just think of, all right, the setting. If I'm listening to this, where would I want to be? What kind of situation would I imagine? And my stuff is mainly just story-based, so that's how I usually write. I know Angel would write based off of experience before, too, with, like, Little Pretty Pink and all this stuff, and a whole bunch of, like, things that we throw at each other. So I think it's mainly that, but it's definitely usually after we write music first, so then we can feel it.
You're buying cheap wine, got a lot of love in this world. Darkness was a friend, long comes the very end. Same damn thing, all over again.
Little Thank you.
Do you guys have a favorite artist or group?
Kate, collectively?
James, you want to answer that? I know you don't have a list.
All right, so first is Smash Mouth, their hit single All Star. Second is R. Kelly, his hit single Ignition. That's it. Yeah, that's it.
I think it's pretty tough to say that we all like have a single artist that we all look up to because we all come from very different musical backgrounds.
As an artist, you have a huge impact on your audience. So what do you guys want your music to bring to your audience?
For me personally, when making music of any kind, it can be with Floral Jacket or whoever I'm playing with, I just want to make people feel exactly what I'm feeling while playing music, because it's the best feeling in the world. That's why we do it. We love to perform and we love to express ourselves in this way that we can't express ourselves in any other way. That's why we choose music. So
crazy on your low, the way you walk across the room is just a low. Oh, got me dying on my knees, oh, you say, oh no. It's fair, the way you walk around and gee, oh me, it's fair, the way you look at all the walkers of your say. So you tell me all the things you claim in red.
What advice do you have to give to aspiring musicians?
It's like how quick everything happened. I mean, we just had this project in the summer, and before that I was thinking, man, I really want to do music with a band. Like, that would be great, even though it's unique and it can be different and weird, like, to just go for it. Like I said, when it comes to subcategories, there's no label, so don't create a label, don't create a small box for yourself in categories for who you think would like it. It's not who you think would like it, is you like it. Let's hope other people can listen as well.
don't limit yourself, you know, don't limit yourself to a certain thing or a genre, or like try to live up to other people's standards, you know, and just go with the flow, you know, like you don't rush things, don't just take it step by step, because, you know, I know some aspiring musicians that want to rush things, and they just, like, you know, they want to go in the studio when they only have, like, barely a song, you know, they, like, they want to go in the studio now, they want to start performing right now, you know, they want to get famous right now, rich and quick, you know, and that's not how it works, you know, it takes time, it takes practice, it takes a lot of work before you can really get out there and, you know, be well known in your area, you know.
What's been the most surprising thing you guys have learned either by yourselves or your group during this journey so far?
The most surprising thing that I've learned is something I learned today, because I was really stressed out before this. And it turned out all right. It turned out pretty cool. So you just gotta like let go sometimes. Just go with it. Anybody have anything else?
I feel like I've definitely learned the, like, being with this group specifically, the importance of being good friends within the group while also playing, like, that definitely helps the music sound better. It seems like the tighter you are relationship-wise, the tighter the music gets too.
Recording is hard. Recording is tiring. 8 hours in one day straight, and then 2 days in a row. That I wasn't prepared for that. But now I know I will be. I will get like 24 hours of sleep before the next time we record.
The tyrants of fever sing in veins, the pardon of his lips, and though I can't forget the rest, lost is no regret. On the north, on the north, and day over now, I feel a little weak. Yeah, I know the wood of life just bring me to the field. Oh yeah. Near your bliss, although I confess all my sins, I'll do it all again. I'm a now.
How do you guys plan on continuing your musical career? Because I can already tell you guys have a bright future ahead of yourselves.
Well, like Angel was talking about earlier when she was saying the recording is really hard. We just did finish recording at Expression Studio, and it's 3 songs so far. We've been writing a lot more lately, so we have 3 songs, and hopefully they're coming out soon.
Well, last but not least, where can we check you guys out?
Young promoter.
You can check us out on Facebook and Instagram. Floral Jacket Instagram with the little at sign, and on Facebook just Floral Jacket. That's on all of our social media. By the way, I'm also a band photographer. Check me out at angelsphotography.tumblr.com.
But soon, to answer other parts of the music wise, we are actually creating a band camp soon, so we can start releasing the demos that are coming out.
My life, there you go. Oh, these
right. Thank you guys so much. Again, we're Floral Jacket from Fairfield, California.